All right, I am live. Awesome. Okay, hey everybody, what's up? I was dying to go live today. Many reasons, but before that, welcome. Thank you for joining. I appreciate your time that you guys share with me here on these lives. A lot of information, And I needed to come on live today. One, this is a new application that I'm using to go live, to stream to multiple places. I should be streaming to not only YouTube, but Facebook and Twitter. So supposedly this is working. You can see I have this little tinker thing going down here. So give me feedback. I can see comments on here. So give me feedback and tell me what you think, how this is going. If there's any lag, if anything is going on. Please give me lag. Give me comments and feedback so I can know to see exactly what's going on. Whether you leave it on Facebook, on Twitter, I can always check that later on YouTube. But I should be able to see it here. Oh, here we go. I have somebody from Twitter. Okay, I have somebody from Facebook. All right, I'm on Facebook. Thank you there, Miss Stephanie. All right, I'm on Facebook and I got blogger sexy. All right, then we got Armando Perez. What's up? Sounds great. Looks great. Awesome. That's on YouTube. So all three, check out. I'm live on all of them. Clear as a whistle. Beautiful. This is going to be, the new one that I'm going to be using is awesome. I can even share a screen, which I'm going to be doing later. But to get to the point, one of the things that I wanted to talk about today, we've always been talking about foundational exams. And yes, I am wearing glasses, for those of you that are curious. Because these are reading glasses, okay? I can see far away, but if I wanted to see letters, really like for like book reading, these are my reading glasses that I'm getting so far. Sunshine, what's up? What's up? Okay. I'm going to get this out of the way before we go into anything, because we're going to talk about the order of examinations and a couple studying tips, things of that nature. But one of the things I want to get out of the way is this. I'm going to share my screen now and tell me if you see it. Share screen. I'm going to share this screen. Tell me if you see the screen that I'm sharing. Do you guys see it? Do you guys see the screen? Is something in your way? Let me bring this down if you don't see it because that's in the way. Do you see the screen? Do you see the screen? Do you see the screen? Give me a yes. Give me a no. Give me a thumbs up, thumbs down, whatever it is. This is very important to me. This is very important to me because I almost lost it this weekend, okay, because of this. All right, awesome. Very good. This is what's going on. Okay. I got a whole bunch of good. That's awesome. That's awesome. The comments came in at one shot. I'm glad you can see this. These are valid wildcard masks. These are going to follow you between Network Plus, Microsoft, CCNA, definitely CCMP. But the thing is with the CCMP, and Sunshine can vouch for this, you're not going to be taught how to wildcard mask. The way that I teach wildcard masking, all right, that's fine. This is very simple to do, and I have it on another monitor, so that's why I'm looking this way. Basically, you put a constant number. This is the easy way. This is one way of doing it. And then you put your subnet mask. Let's say that 20, right? That's 255, that's 255, that 240.0, right? And then you subtract, okay? And then you have 0, 0, 15, 25. There's your wildcard mask. That's as hard as it gets. Okay. If you guys are used to using my method, that means that the same mask we have 8 bits on, 8 bits on, 4 bits on. That's 16, right? Line. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 16, right? That bit value right there is 16. So therefore, this is, if the sum of those bits is 15, this is 255, and the X's are zeros. This is wildcard mask. It doesn't get any more difficult than this. If you go anywhere online, this is what they teach you. This is what they teach you in Network Plus. This is what they teach you in CCNA. Maybe that's what they teach you in Microsoft. I don't know. I don't have much faith in their IP skills, but hey. I know I did, but I in my skills, yes. But this is wildcard masking. It's consecutive. And then over the weekend, And Sunshine can vouch for this, okay? We got, I don't know the exact IP address. That's how, whatever I got. They were using a Setter 26. What does it mean when you're using a Setter 26? What does it mean? You're in the fourth octave, right? Hi, lads. Pass my CCNA 213. Woo! Way to go, Ray. Way to go. Congratulations, brother. I'm glad I was here to help. You did the hard work, my man. You did the studying. You burned the midnight oil. You got it. Congrats. Next step. It's not over. This is a journey. Next step, right? We're going to get your security plus your CCNP. All right? But take a look at that IP address, right? This means that this thing, let me put myself in the picture. Here goes, this is pretty cool. I just like to test this out. Hey, there I am. No, but you can't see that. That's pretty big there. That's pretty big. Can I put myself smaller? No, there goes that. Now let me just put this. Okay, so there it is right there, okay? 26 masks. That's zero. This wildcard mask, if you were to do it, it's a mask 255.255.255. Then there's what? It's a 26. That means there's two bits on. That's 24. That's a 192. That's it. 192, which means x.x.x.11123456, which means this is 0, 0, 0. And these two right here, that's 64, that bit value one right next to the line, 64. So this is 63. Raz has the best expression of submitting. Thank you, Steve. Thank you, brother. Because that's just the way it is. But guess what? They threw this at me. And I'm going to put it right here. Has be there for prosperity. Has anyone ever seen this mask? Now, I can tell you right now, I have asked all my colleagues. I called. I researched. Only one location, which I'm not going to name, they said, yeah, you can do that because wildcard mask doesn't need to be consecutive. That's what they said. But I asked a particular colleague of mine, which I will not say his name because I don't know if he wants me to say it or not. So I'm not going to say his name. That he actually went above and beyond, spoke to a double CCIE, who's a double CCIE in the field, right, for 20, 30 years, whatever, and said, no, that's not a valid subnet mask because it's not consecutive. The iOS will accept it, which is true. The packet tracer accepts it. In CML2, it accepts it. I haven't tried it in GNS3. Okay? So the iOS is accepting this wildcard mask. But think about what this is saying. Zeros mean match exactly the first two octets. This means I really don't care what numbers here from 1 to 255. All right, or 0 to 255, but match exactly this. But wait a minute. We're here. So what? There's no mathematical logic to this. So it made me go insane. But I was proven that I was right and that all of you are right in the way that you were explained wildcard masking, the way I explained it in my book, the way I explained it on YouTube, on my live boot camps. How people are explaining it out there, okay? They are consecutive. This is not a valid wild card mask. It's not going to work. Prove me wrong. Prove me wrong. So it's already been, I've already gotten a documentation to state that that is an invalid wild card mask. So that's one of the things that I wanted to talk about because that's insane, okay? That's really, That's not true. That's crazy. Okay. Because yeah, no, that's not going to happen. Okay. So that's one of the things that got me. And this is why the first, but I want to get this out of the way. When you're studying for your certification, I don't care who you use, whatever books you use, whatever instructor you use, however you're doing it, you're doing it by yourself, you're going on YouTube, I don't care. But you better be granular in the explanations. Totally awesome. You put in the work and you're on your way even more. That's right. That's right. Yes, he did. Okay. Okay. Well, Sunshine, here she is. Someone mentioned to me that while mask doesn't have to be consecutive, but I doubt that. Yeah, I doubt that answer too. I saw that too, and that's just a lie. That's a lie. That's a lie. They don't know what the hell they're talking about. Okay, that's insane. Mathematically, it doesn't make sense. Looking at it, okay, I want to match these two and the last one. I don't care what's in the middle. Anybody can understand that. And you know, in kindergarten, anybody can understand that. But when you try to look at the logic based on that prefix of 26, it doesn't make it. It's not mathematically correct. It's a willy-nilly, I pick whatever I want. I don't care if you're trying to filter out networks or what have you. That's not going to work, which is already said by a double CCIE who is in the field, okay, and knows what he's talking about. All right, so yeah, no. And I already have documentation on it, all right, stating certain errors that have been that had to be corrected. Okay, so this is what I'm saying. When you start studying for your Network Plus, okay, or you start studying for your CCNA or whatever certification, I don't care what it is, when you're going through the book, really pay attention, highlight. Listen, I got the rainbow of highlights. You know how when we were kids, we would get 120 colors of crayon colors? What's up, Jason? I got you, bro. Don't worry about that. I forgot about you. I got you. Okay. When you're studying for your certification, okay, you remember crayons, the Crayola crayons? You have all the colors, right? So in highlighters, and so I can highlight things, I got all the colors. To me, the colors is what makes sense. Yellow, green, red, what have you. All right, brother, all right. So as you go through this, see the differences in their terminology. See the differences in their example. You got to ask yourself these questions when you're going through. Wait a minute. Where did this network come from? Well, how are we connecting from one router to another? They didn't put that in there. All of these things you got to look at, all right? Because a book, I don't care if Shakespeare's writing it or whoever's writing it, okay, is not going to be perfect. There's going to be errors. That's why they have erratas, all right? When I wrote my book, I made a bunch of typos, okay? And they sent me back, and I sent them back all the corrections. They were just lazy, and they printed the book before I gave them the changes, so they only changed it in the Kindle version because it's easy because they already printed the book. So that's why I tell people don't buy the printed book, buy the Kindle version. So you really got to go through it with a fine-tooth comb, especially for the CCMP. Sunshine, who's this? Sunshine, it says what? It allows for input, but it will work. Sunshine, what do you mean? But it will work. We said highlights. Do you have a crash course on distribution list? No, I don't have a crash course on distribution list. I know for some reason somebody told me that they were getting questions on distribution list and CCNA. Why? You're taking the test at the wrong place. Okay, you shouldn't be asked that. But distribution lists start at the CCMP. They're not difficult to understand, but again, you're matching them up with an access list and applying them to your routing protocol. All right, because all these route maps and all these DLs and all these prefix lists, and even now with communities with BGP, it's like, you know, before you would just configure it in BGP, send community both standard or expanded. Now we're creating like a IP community standard and then, you know, internet. No advertise, you know, all these different things that just doesn't make any sense. And you have these numbers, you know, :: it's either a metric, and then autonomous system, :: it's crazy. And when it comes to that, it's a number. So there's a lot of things to look at in mind that you're taking a test, that they cannot be that detailed oriented. Okay, they cannot be that detail oriented because it's 102 questions. You got a minute and 17 seconds to answer these questions, and there's no freaking labs. Okay, I can tell you that right now. So don't think that they're going to be that granular. Mike, I have the Cisco Press CCMP 3.0.50.4.1, so do I, book, and I have noticed a lot of typos in it. Unfortunately, that is true. I had typos in mind. Every author that has ever created a book, but the thing is the publisher. The publisher should have known better and done the fixes before they put out the book, because, you know, it had a lot of typos, a lot of typos. I know a lot of people have been complaining about it, okay? And Sunshine can attest to this. Going through it, we found a lot of missing items that should have been in there, all right? When we're doing labs and when we're trying to do things and things are not working, and we're following it per the book, because really we're following outputs. Some of them are actual syntaxes for configurations. But one of the things you need to, that's why we say not to skip foundations. Herb, Jolie, Lewis, okay, Adam, these are guys. I thank the heavens, okay, that these guys came, that I came across these guys, and they're now part of my team, okay? And we're creating a hell of a team, because I know I reached out to them first, and they did their 100%, if not more, to find out the answer for me. All right. Even Jolie, when I told him that wildcard message, like, what is that? But this is why you can't skip the foundations. All right. Because once you get to the CCNP, Mike, I think it's Mike, right? Mike. Yeah. CCNA exam does not test you on non-consecutive wildcard mask and access list. That's correct. And even in the CCNP, before they start talking about prefix list or route maps or anything like that, they talk about wildcard mask, and they give you the same examples that I just showed you. They give you these examples. Let me bring this back up here so you guys can see it. Okay, they give you, well, for the whole thing, they give you these examples. They don't give you that weird example. They don't give you this guy right here. They don't give you that. They give you this. Okay, so why did they come up with that? I mean, I don't know. Whatever, move on, okay? Move on and create your own lab. But this is why I reached out to everybody to find out if I was going insane or what, because I was. And when I finally got the validation that I was correct, I was relaxed. Okay, because I'm saying, Mike, have I been teaching this wrong for the past 20 years? What the hell? All right, so no. That's why foundational exams are important, and your, not theirs, your granularity on looking at what you're reading, especially at the CCNP level, because at the CCNP and above, they actually take a lot of things for granted that you should know. Okay, because you could be working in IT for 100 years. But if you never set up, and it's funny because we just went over it, if you never set up an IGMP server or session, you're never going to know that, right? So, and that's something that's just part of that test, okay? Should I study Cisco even if my environment does not have Cisco? Also, if I sit and pass the exam, I won't be working on Cisco devices soon. How useful will the skills be? Definitely they'll be useful, regardless. I can tell you right now, I'm Cisco, and when I went to work for Metro, they were using Alcatel-Lucent, and it's pretty similar. It's just like saying, should I learn? Well, it's not like saying Windows and Linux. It's like saying Windows 7, Windows 10, okay, Vista, things like that. That's a little bit different navigation, but the concepts are the same. Ethernet, IP is IP, EHRP is EHRP. If you're using these routing protocols, BGP, GRE tunnels, DMVPNs, all these are the same. So Cisco is worldwide. Cisco is worldwide, and they're not going out of business anytime soon. So it behooves you to get that. I've seen a router that violated the VLSM rule. I think Cisco router's intelligence is high. I not the router itself, the iOSs and the programmers that create this, right? But also, let me pose this question to you. If I am in BGP, or if I am inside, I go router, BGP, whatever. Or I'm inside router EIGRP, okay? Why do I have to type EIGRP or BGP again to get to somewhere else? I understand typing IPv4 address families, or IPv6, or VPNv4, VPNv6, but why do I need to type EIGRP again if I'm already in EIGRP? That's a programming thing. No, I'm Cisco all the way too, bro. Cisco all the way. I love Cisco. I've been teaching Cisco for 20 years and I enjoy it. I love it. But you need to question it because you need to understand it. There was something I saw on Instagram today that says, if it doesn't challenge you, then you're not growing. Okay? So when I look at certain things in a book, I want to say, okay, why? And that's one of the things that I love about a lot of my students, all right? And especially now that I'm teaching the CCMP, Sunshine is one of them. She goes, well, why is this and why is that? That's why I like these questions. And she poses very good questions so we can go ahead and get to the bottom of that and then do our own lab and figure it out, okay? I read on YouTube that Cisco will be obsolete soon. Better to study cloud. It's the future. Well, I don't know about that. More Cisco, 100%. Hey, there's my dad, Mr. Luis Diaz. Saludo de Orlando. All right. Hey, now that he's there, one of the things that I've been pondering, I want to do a live. I don't know what you guys tell me who will be interested in something like this. Y'all know I'm Cuban and I speak Spanish. I'm pondering because, man, I recorded myself in Spanish and I'm like, my God, if I put this out in Spanish, I'm going to ruin my reputation. But I want to, because my Spanish, I can speak Spanish. But again, it's to be more, you know, professional. I want to start practicing that. So who of you out there, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, will be interested in doing a live with me in Spanish? Okay? Just to test it out. Those of you that are bilingual, trilingual, contigual, I mean, I don't know. If you know how to speak Spanish, would you like to do a live in Spanish with me? I'm not trying to cut anybody off. I just want to test myself to see how this is going. So if you're interested, shoot me an email to info@networkingdollars.com or leave your comments on Facebook, YouTube, right here. Tell me now if you would like to see something like that, because I really would like to do something. I mean, I am Cuban. I should, you know, say something in Spanish. But anyway, I just thought I'd throw out there. By the way, I have this little ticker going across the bottom here. I'm sure you've noticed it, that it says, register to join my Wednesday live online at Global.net. What is that live online? I'm doing a 10 to 4 on Wednesday for a CCNA refresher. It's going to be based on the topics that people have the most issues, like IPv6, ACLs, okay, things of that nature, okay, that are the more important topics. I'm going to be programming, I can tell you that. You know, somebody told me there he was asked tons of questions in programming. I'm Argentinian, okay. Oh, my, okay. My dad thinks that's a good idea. All right. I'm Argentinian. I speak Spanish. I would love to. Okay, great. Okay, but alas, I don't. If I speak Spanish, oh, but you don't. Okay. Yes, I would. But no habla español. All right, Sunshine. But we'll get you to speak Spanish, okay? But, okay, so, you know, if enough people are interested, I will do it. I will do it. I'll just do it just for the heck of it because I just want to see how I do on that. But anyway, back to the point at hand. We need to make sure before, just like when you go shopping, okay, for a car, for a home, for clothes, food, we're very finicky, right? What clothes we wear, what food we buy, what car, and you know, the house, the location, you know, whatever. We're very finicky on that, but we're quick to jump to a particular book or a particular author. Or, and then just go with it and just take it as is. Don't do that. Don't do that. Don't do that. When you go study, okay, when you study, at least when I study, when I choose a book, I look at the reviews, I look at the author, how many years of experience, okay? Oh, you're welcome, you're welcome. Okay, no, that wasn't me, all right. Ooh, all right, so I definitely look into whose book I'm going to use. And I'll be quite honest with you. The book that I've used all my life, pretty much, especially for the CCNA, is The Cybex by Todd Lamley. Always, always. Did I use a Cisco Press book because I was a Cisco instructor at an actual brick and mortar school? I had no choice. It was a Cisco Academy. So I had to get, you know, do the Cisco test and all that stuff. So I had to use Cisco Press. But by far, Cisco Press, I'm not saying it's bad, not the least. Is very granular. The dialogue is very high. I've always said it in every live that I've gone to. that if you pass the Cisco Networking Academy, they should just give you your CCNA because the test is easier than the Cisco Networking Academy because they really get very granular with their information. Okay, so that's important. But with Cybex, and in this case, Todd Lamley, his books, okay, CCNA, CCNP, Network Plus, all his books are very straight to the point. He's a funny guy, okay, and he's good. He's good, and he gives you the information in a very easy to understand method, all right? So that's in my opinion. Other people want to go to O'Reilly or whatever else, whatever, whoever you think you can understand the best, whatever author. Some people don't listen. Some people don't like it because I'm too loud. Oh, well, okay. There's other instructors out there. I'm not screaming at you. As they say in the service, I'm just talking loud and clear so I can make sure you hear and understand me. Okay. That's just the way I am. Okay. Exactly. Oh, Mrs. Diaz, Cybex is with an S. Just so you know, a little typo there. I know your hands are hurting, so that's why. But it's Cybex is with an S. Cybex and Amazon. Go take a look at that. Todd Lamley books are written in a way that's easier to read versus Wendell Oldham books and are kind of wordy. Oh yeah, well, it's not just Wendell Oldham. Poor guy. Don't blame Wendell Oldham. But you like in the CCMP, I'm not mentioning their names, but there's four CCIEs. Why are they four CCIEs? They're writing that book. There's another thing you need to consider when you're taking this new CCMP. You're taking, it's okay. You're taking a CCIE written and a CCNP route. It's two, think about it. It's two, well, really it's CCMP route, CCMP switch, right? But it's two of those. This is like something this big, books that we had to study before, and now we're studying something this big. Okay? This is the new book, right? That's it. This is both CCMP, we'll see, like that. CCMP and CCIE, okay? So think about what's going on there. It's very generalized. It's very generalized, and it's assuming a lot of different things, okay? And it's assuming a lot of different things. And that's the way it is. That's the way it is, okay? And you gotta be careful with that when you're taking this new cert. Now, I see a lot of people taking these certs, excuse me. I gotta take the Fountain of Youth water, all right? I mean, I look young, I haven't shaved. It's been a hell of a week. The week just started, but I don't have a week. My week, I don't have a weekend or a week, okay? But yes, be wise. Be wise, choose wisely in your books, in your videos, and who you see in YouTube. All right, because they could be somebody that just passed their CCNA. They brain dumped their CCNP. They brain dumped their CCNA. They goes, I know guys with 50, 100 certifications, and they don't know anything. Okay, they don't know anything. They go, don't be a paper engineer. Know your stuff. Okay. Where can you get Amazon? Where? This book right here, the Cisco Press and Amazon. Live en Español. Servía muy bueno, las. Encantado. Yo lo voy a hacer. Va a ser un poco cómico, pero lo voy a hacer. I just said I'm going to do it. Listen, I taught una clase inalámbrica. A wireless class. For Spaniards. So they were in Spain and I was here, you know, in the US and I taught them. Why is that a big deal? We both speak Spanish, right? Well, Cuban Spanish is different than Spaniard Spanish. They call it Castellano. It's completely different. They were great students. They were awesome. They were engineers. They're all live. They worked for the public school system. They were awesome. So they helped me in the verbiage. Okay. So I don't go wrong. Thanks. You're welcome. You're welcome, Martin. You're welcome. You're welcome. But so I am going to do it. I'm going to test it out. Be gentle. Okay. Be gentle. Now, speaking of certifications, I said, go in order, please, please, pretty please. Network Plus, CCNA, CCMP. CCMP is both CCMP and CCIE. Cisco went nuts and allowed people and not give any requirements to the CCMP. That's insane. They've opened the door to paper CCMPs. You don't be that person. Don't be that person. Because when you go to the interview, if you pass the HR, you get to that IT person, you better know what the hell you're doing. Okay? Because Cisco used to say, before you take your CCMP, you must have at least 5 years of experience in the field before you take your CCMP. So now you got a person that just graduated from high school or they got their degree in college and networking, and I'm going to take my CCMP, and they fail it miserably. And then they wonder why. I spent $120,000 in college. I'm in debt and I can't pass the certification. How is that? Because you wasted 2 years of art, psychology, philosophy, I don't know, English, trigonometry, physics, you know, all this craziness. And then maybe you touched one or two computers. You touched a computer. You may have touched maybe one or two routers and you may have configured them. So that is what I'm trying to tell you. You got to be very, very careful how you plan, okay, your journey into IT. What do you like? And if you choose networking, do not skip. Do not skip. Do not skip. Do not skip. Because you're going to pay for it in the long run. I think in the last live, I broke it down for you guys. All those certifications came out to under $3,000, I think it was. I got the paperwork somewhere around here. Yep, right here. It was the Network Plus, Security Plus, the CCNA, the CCMP, Linux, and A Plus under $2,000. $2,000, okay? You go to college 4 years, you spend $120,000, and then you're going to go work at Starbucks, okay? That's not happening. But I'm going to talk about that in a second. I got something to say about that. Linux course, yes, Linux. Jolie should be putting his Linux course up shortly. Okay, so be looking for it in globed.net. That's why you got to subscribe to it. Jolie will be, he's the Linux guy. He'll be putting his course up there shortly. For now, I'm relying mainly on my physical labs. That's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. I love labbing. Awesome. Anyone have taken the new CCNA? Are there a lot of, no, there's no sims. In the 200-301, there's no simulations. It's all multiple choice, drag and drop. Now, will you get a snippet of a configuration and then a multiple choice answer that says, or a multiple response that says, which of the following syntaxes or commands would you have to type in order to be able to configure the following? That you'll see, but you will not be going into a router. You will not be going into a switch. You'll be just clicking away. Okay. So that's why you need to be very good at that. This is why I'm doing the CCNA refresher on Wednesday. Look at that ticker, go to globed.net, take a look at that course. Don't be coming later on, man. I should have, could have, would have. Do it. You want to make sure you pass. Okay? I connected GNS3 Labs with EVNG Labs together. Oh, man, that's awesome. You got to shoot me to see how to, well, I took away EVNG, but guess what? Get what, ladies and gentlemen? I paid for CML too. I paid for it. I'm sorry. I don't like to pee people under the bus, but I got to say it. CML2 is great in the sense that there's, you know, they have high-end routers, okay? I don't like the fact that there's an Ubuntu desktop. Well, at least it forced me to learn, I have to learn Linux, okay, which I'm taking my Linux Plus next year, okay? I couldn't believe, I would never have even said that years ago, but I'm going to do it. I have to do it. Everybody better take their Linux, so because that's the route, okay? But, too many, dude, I am the issue, right? Because users are quick to blame the software, right? But I mean, you can drag things out, connect things. They have a little thing that says connectivity. It doesn't show you. I don't see the labels. Right on the drawing arc in GNS3 or the packet tracer, it shows you where you're connected F0, F01, or 000 to 001. Whatever the case may be, you can create little labels. Hey, this is the network for this length. This is the network for that length. yeah, you can't do that. Or I don't think you can. I don't think you can, because I haven't been able to figure that out. Also, in my VM, I gave it 100 gigs of space. Well, guess what? The web interface for Sigmo 2 doesn't see that. If it wasn't for Sunshine showing me where to go on a particular web page that she found out through I don't know who and I don't know what other places she went to find that out, she showed me how to go into the controller for that CML GUI so I can then add that partition of 100 gigs to my CML so the CML can recognize it. And I'm like, Sunshine, where did you get this info? It's not in the documentation. I didn't see where that was. She had to hunt for it. She found it and she hooked me up. How about that? So I'm not using CML anymore. I'm now using EVNG. Okay, I'm not using EVNG. Yes, I downloaded it this weekend and I'm using, not EVNG, I'm sorry, GNS3. I'm using GNS3 now, period. End of story. I'm not using anything else but GNS3 because I want to be able to see things. I want to be able to do things. And yeah, CML2 is not happening. And the routers take forever to boot. Sunshine, yay. Wish I knew these certs existed before I went for my... Yeah, brother. Certs hold more weight than any college degree in IT. From someone who has a master... take it from someone who has a master's degree. Damn, Jason. Awesome, bro. All right. CCNA is your best path to a better job, a better life. Even if you're not going to be touching Cisco gear in the short term, having your CCNA is a long term opens many doors. Definitely. Now, I've always said that degrees, today, let's talk about today, right now, this minute. You have your kids going to college, stop them. Stop them. Okay? If they're going to get, I'm going to get an IT degree. Unless they're going to become psychologists, or they're going to become, I don't know, social workers, they're going to become doctors, lawyers, you know, things like that. Well, then you can't stop them. You can't stop them. Okay. But if I were to go to college, if you tell me, Laz, we're going to pay your college, bro. What path would you take? Right. What degree do you want? You have all these certifications, but what degree would you want? I want a degree in bullshitting. I want an actual BS degree. I want a degree where I can become a hustler, where I can go ahead and I can talk my way around everybody, right? I can BS my way with my BS, okay? Because that's what it is. Let me give you an example of what I'm talking about. I went to school with a certain individual, all right? We both got our A pluses together. But this individual, when you got your certification, that particular institution put your picture up on the wall, right? My picture never went up on the wall. Why did this individual's picture get up on the wall? Well, when that individual came to school, he said hello to everybody. Hey, hi, how are you? How you doing? Nice to see you. Good to see you. Hey, what's up? Here's some bonbons for you. Here's some flowers for you. Oh, here's a card for you. Anything I can do for you. So he's a politician. So if you're going to get a degree, you got to become, if you want to get a degree, get a degree in something to do with, you know, political science, I don't know, something that it teaches you how to BS, all right? How to talk to people, a salesperson. See, experience has made me a salesperson. That's why when I got a job at Bell South, I was able to answer the questions and I knew what they wanted to hear. I didn't go to college for that. Experience, I learned through fire, okay? But if you are, you know, determined on going to college, get a degree on how to sell yourself, because there's people out there right now, like the people in Miami-Dade County public school system that don't know even how to secure their own network from a 16-year-old that hacked them, okay, that they're in IT. But yet they tell you you can't get a job. I know no students, and Jason, I don't know if Jason knows this guy. I forgot this guy's name. Man, intelligent kid. Got a job in Best Buy, became the best computer fixer, assembler, whatever, bench technician that they had, right? People got envious of him. He was just doing his job. They created some scenario to fire that kid, and they fired him for no reason, okay? because you have to be, oh my God, it's Hurricane Andrew coming down here. Okay. All right. You have to be, you got to know how to BS around all this stuff. So if you're going to get a degree, or I don't know, read a Tony Robbins book. Look at, oh my God, Mrs. Diaz, who's my favorite speaker. I can't believe I can't say his name now. The person that I listen to. 100%. I have noticed labs are being in real world scenarios. It's totally different. Yeah, it's totally different. IT bachelor here. I don't know anything about networks at all. Lots of theories and studying unrelated courses. Exactly. Exactly. All right. You need get your certifications, your Network Plus, your CCNA, Linux Plus, Secure. Get all those CompTIA certs out of the way. All right. I mean, people say, I always say that A plus, but A plus is very important as well. Why is my computer running slow? All right. Can this NIC card support this? You know, if you want to change, you know, video cards, all these different things, CPU, you at least to be a good consumer, a smart consumer when you're purchasing a computer, because when you go to these stores, you think those people know anything? They don't know what, they know how to sell. They know how to read what's on the box, memorize it, then regurgitate it back to you. But do you know what they're telling you? No. That's why when my stepdaughter watches the thing for Mac, what is that? When Mac comes out with something new, they have this, the show, whatever. So she wants me to watch it so I can look at the text, the specs. I said, okay, wow. Oh yeah. Ooh, that's man. I want the computer. All right. Les Brown. Les Brown. Thank you, Mrs. Diaz. Les Brown, high school diploma only, making or made millions. He was preaching and teaching motivational speeches, but life, he was coaching, okay? People with PhDs, he wrote books, he didn't go to college, and he tells you he didn't go to college. Life, right? Showed him that. And how bad do you want it? Okay, so in IT, in our realm, search with the right person, with the right book, the right videos, and the right attitude on your behalf. Because if you do choose this career, it's you're an ever-learning student. I don't care if you're a Cisco architect, the top of the pinnacle. It's ever-evolving and ever-changing, and it's going to be challenge you every step of the way because things will break on you and you don't know why they broke. All right? There's no such thing as a network that's 100% up. That's unrealistic. Okay, hold on. Let me see what's on comments here. Hey, what's up, Imad? How can I study to prepare for certificates and working in the same time? Any tips? Yes, I do. Agreed. Time management. That's true. Read Tony Robbins. He's awesome. My wife has his books. For formal education will make you a living. Self-educating will make you a fortune. Formal education will make you a living. Self-education will make you a fortune. Okay. I can tell you right now. Okay, first let me answer Imad. Imad, when I was going through school, all right, I was married, second marriage. Been married now with her for 21 years. Three kids, my daughter, my stepdaughter, and a stepson who is autistic. Okay? She decided to say, quit your job. I'm going to go to work. Full-time, you're going to go to school full-time. Wherever I went, the mall, anywhere, I took the books with me. I read and read and read and read and read and read and read. And I was able, there were simulators, some Mickey Mouse simulators back at that time, that I was able to play around with and pass my certifications. Okay? But I knew the page number, the paragraph, the sentence, the word. Okay? And I was always that guy who had his arm up asking questions. So in today's environment, that you have all these e-learning platforms, YouTube, Google, Wikipedia, you have all these things at your fingertips, forums that you can join and you can get answers, okay? And like I said, a college education is gonna cost you no less than, let's say, $5,000 a year, okay? Some 20, $50 a year. Okay. So when you walk out of UM, it's going to be 200 grand that you're in debt. Will you have a job? No. I know a student of mine that he couldn't configure a router to save his life, but he had to pass. And this is why you need to make sure you choose the correct technical institution and the instructor that's in front of you is teaching you, not BSing you. Okay? Because those educational, those .coms, right? Because if you're not a .edu, you're not really accredited. You're accredited by a cheesier accreditation because you don't want to go through the problems of going to the SACS accreditation that goes to the school board to get that .edu. But still, there's some businesses that still have a .com, okay? And they still have a school, but they hire people that can't teach. Case in point, I was a Cisco instructor in a lot of these places, okay? And the Microsoft instructors say, no, the Cisco instructor will teach you IP. What does that mean? An MCSC does know nothing about IPs? Do you not have to configure the HTTP server? Do you not have to put statically assigned addresses? Do you not need to make reservations? Do you not need to know IP for Microsoft? Why does the Cisco instructor have to teach you that? And I did. I had to, because the certified MCSEs back in those days didn't know crap about IP. What is this? How much experience do you need before to become a CCIE? A lot. Les Brown, motivational speaker. Yes, from Miami, Dade County. Yeah, he's my brother. You're never told to start. Damn right. This is at Skin Beauty. Love am I. Harley, you're young. It's unbelievable. I'm 57 years old, getting back into IT networks. I'm 54. Last started in his early 30s. That's right. So Scholar, thank you so much for your response. Definitely encouraging. This is interesting. Let me go back to that question. It's not too late to enter the IT field. How much experience do you need to be a CCIE? I can tell you right now, when I took my CCIE hands-on boot camp, because you better take it before you go take that test. That doesn't mean you're going to pass it. Those guys, and I took it with INE, those guys from INE go a million miles an hour. They can make routers dance. They know those troubleshooting because obviously they created the scenario, so they know how to troubleshoot it. All right. And they know the concepts very well. They do it every single freaking day. It's just like a high school teacher that teaches math for 20 years, same book, maybe a little changes here and there, not with the stupid math that they have. But it's still, you're teaching math. If you do it for 20 years, it's going to become second nature to you. So INE people, they're like triple CCIEs, quadruple CCIEs. It's because they do it every single day. They do it every single day. So they get you ready. But I know people that were in that classroom, and it was a full classroom, it was like 30-something people in there. I was the only one that didn't work for a service provider. Everybody in there worked for a service provider. A lot of them already failed the test once or twice. One guy had failed it 12 times and he's still trying. And the thing with that is when you fail it once, you got to wait. Maybe I don't remember the exact time, but let's say if you fail it once, you got to wait a month. If you fail it twice, you got to wait 3 months. If you fail it, so this guy's been trying to take the CCIE for 15 years, but he can't. Why? Because one of the things that I tell people, the people that have the hardest problems passing Network Plus, CCNA, CCMP or CCIE are real network engineers. People that see real problems that users create, right? Things that happen. But when you get into a testing environment, they're generating scenarios that you never put yourself in. You need to understand how to get out. That's the issue. That's the problem. Okay, so you're going in there with your real world engineer mind and you're failing because you say, well, this is what I do at work, but they don't care what you do at work. They want the Cisco answer. They want the Microsoft answer. They want the CompTIA answer. That's the problem. Understand the concepts. Yes. Okay. But the scenarios that they put you in is scenarios that you would never, it's like a 5-year-old. Well, I can't even say that. A 2-year-old took your computer and just started banging on the keyboard and erased something in the registry. And now your computer won't boot and you don't know why. Okay, so it's like that is the type of things that happen when you take certifications. Okay, let's see here. Lately, I find I need more what? Quantity than quality. It's not that there's more quantity. They do teach a lot. That day, I think the classes were 12 hours long. It was for 10 days. All right. It was morning breakfast when I got there, and it was late. It was dark when I left. Very dark. Okay. There's a lot of stuff you cover in a very short period of time. There's no way you can just absorb all that information. I couldn't even take notes. So I have the videos. Okay. There's no way you can take notes. I know I couldn't. Okay. There are some people in there that have already done this once or twice, so they're very comfortable. That's why they say that the average person that takes their CCIE fails 2.5 times. Or is it 1.5 times? I think it's 2.5 times. That's too expensive, man. I think it's $1,300 or $1,500 for the test. It's an 8-hour test. Okay. And it's all troubleshooting. No, I don't care. I really don't. And do you see anybody else teaching that exam out there? All these big names that I saw, CCNP, CCNA, okay? Books, live boot camps, like I've done it. I've never seen anybody else do that, okay? They don't want to because it's just too much stuff and people will get frustrated. What do you think my CCNP started? How long ago? When did it start? Sunshine, when did it start? It was like, we're in our third week. I don't remember. Let me see. Well, no, I think it's, third week. Whatever. It goes all the way to December 6th, okay? Every Saturday and Sunday. Laz, where do you get the images for GNS3? What do you mean the images? I know with the new GNS3, there's a video on YouTube that David Bombal has out that shows you how to change the images in GNS3. He actually has a video that you can change it. He shows you how to do that. I just use whatever image is there in GNS3. I don't put any other images in there. So if you're asking if you can change the image, yes. But if you want to really look at the nitty gritty of GNS3, David Bombal will be your guy. All right. Lately, I find okay. So that's why it's not that they do explain, but they listen. Don't go up to an INE instructor and say, can you go over IPv6 for me? He's going to say straight out, nope, I'm not here to teach you IPv6. You should know it by now. Okay. Are you going to teach me access list? Nope. You should know access list by now. So that's the whole thing with INE. They're not going to teach you that. They expect you to know certain things. That's why the CCMP has CCI material. The book expects you to know certain things. CCMP course started August 22nd. There you go. August 22nd. And it's December 6th. Roger that. Okay. Okay. Good. I mean, it's a quick video. You can fast forward through it. Just get to the points towards the end where it shows you how to install it and all that stuff. And then just go towards the end. That's where he talks about going inside it and doing things. Okay. So that's the only thing. It's getting dark in here. My God. You need to have a contract with Cisco to change the images. I know, like David said, that there's certain images in there that you can go back and forth. I really don't care. I'm just happy that I re-downloaded it, and now I can go ahead and put labels. I can increase the font size so I can actually see what I'm doing, because in CML you can't increase the font size. At least I don't know how. And in the actual console, I don't, in the CLI, I can't increase the font. I can't increase it. Okay. So it was just painstaking working with it. And my Cisco account got locked out. So I can't even get into certain routers anymore. So I'm like, you know what? I'm done. So GNS3 all the way. Okay. GNS3 all the way. Get the right images. And remember, that's another thing. It's not .bins, it's .image. When you're working in GNS3, .image, okay? When you're putting it in there. So remember that, okay? CCIE hands-on, okay, that's okay. To get images initially. Oh, yes. Oh, you're talking about the iOS images. Oh, roger that. The iOS, not the pic, I'm sorry. I was thinking of the pictures of the router and the switch. You're talking about the images for, okay, you can get them in Vrl. You create a Cisco account, you can get Vrl images. You know, somebody could be nice and give you a Christmas present. You know what I mean? But if not, yeah, you know, you can go to Cisco and get those Vrl images and load them up to GNS3. You can do that if you see what I'm saying. Yeah, no, CML2, man, was $190, and it includes, you don't need to purchase the images. CML2 comes already with the iOSs. You don't need to purchase anything else. So when you download, when you purchase CML2, it'll come already preloaded with the iOSs. They're including that price. They're including that price, those iOSs in that price. So you don't have to worry about that. But let me warn you, this is what I ran into. With CML2, you can't put labels, meaning you can, you know, you can change the router's name, but you can't, and Sunshine showed me how to do that. All right. But again, it could be me that I don't know how to do it, but I can't increase the font size in the CLI. I can't put labels so I can know what network I'm working in. I can't see the interfaces unless I go to the connectivity tab, which then I leave, you know, the topology behind. So it's a pain. It's just a pain. We were literally having to draw this out, and I would tell them to draw it out or put it in the packet tracer as a, you know, my second monitor, so I know what's what without having to get out of the CLI. So I just not happy, and it takes forever for these routers to boot up. Forever. And God forbid you put a 9000 series router, XR router in there, it's going to take forever. Listen, I got a quad core, i7 quad core, 32 gig computer. And I wiped it all out, all right, just for CML2. And Sunshine had to show me how to go into a website to make sure that the GUI version of it will accept the partition that I created for it. Okay, so think about that. Oh, it's an annual. Yeah, well, I'm canceling that. CML2 is a yearly. Yeah, well, yeah, let's Tech just answered that. It's yearly, annual, $199. I'm canceling that. I'm not paying that for again. No way, no how. GNS3 all the way for me, brother. I got my images already. That's all I need. That's all you need. That's all you need, man. If you got the right images, and you can purchase the images outright, so, or like I said, some, you know, Santa Claus can give you a freaking present, you know what I mean? But you can go ahead and it's is like BCAAs and something else, I don't know, there's recovery stuff. But yeah, with it's just so much easier, and things work so much faster. Because when you're teaching, even when you're working, okay, if you're, imagine your computer when you hit enter and you got to sit there, wait 3 seconds for a letter to pop up. Or you, or like control shift 6 that I do in the packet tracer to break, or control C or control pause break. It don't work in the friggin' CML. So if I, you know, I don't type no IP domain lookup, I'll be sitting there until it decides to time out. I'm like, geez, you know what I mean? It's crazy. So me personally, I wouldn't do it. Okay, what about it? What about the ESXi server? What about it? Want to use it in the VM? What VM are you using? Because, right, get a one-time annual sub to CML, then use the images in EVNG. That should keep you going for a while. There you go. With GNS3, you can go far. You can go far with GNS3 because you can get, I didn't do the VM on GNS3, just did the local. But you can do VM on GNS3, you can do cloud on GNS3. You can, you know, put your servers on GNS3, your physical servers on GNS3. There's a million things you can do with GNS3. And again, I'm not the guy for GNS3. The guy for GNS3 is Dave Van Ball. I mean, I am on GNS3 platform. My courses are there too. But Dave Van Ball is the GNS3 guy. His videos will be the one to watch for GNS3, okay? If you want to know details about it and what servers and what things you can do with it, okay? But again, I can't keep reiterating this enough. I just can't. When you're taking your CCNA, if you're already studying for your CCNA, make sure, listen, from the, first of all, the 200-125 is not old, and the CCNA 200-120 is not old, okay? It's not. The CCNA 200-301 is just that they've added 10 certifications into one, all right? And they're being very generalized, and they changed terminology, period, all right? Now, the CCNA, okay, the new one, the 200-301, where people are going to have issues with, and I tell people, listen, before you take your test, pick the right location. Pick a technical school. Don't go to a mainstream university. They're being tricky in that mainstream university. I think they're putting their fingers in where they don't belong, because they're asking you questions and you're able to do whatever you want on those routers back in when you were doing simulations. So don't do it. But when you're studying for it, just for your new CCNA, just look at the terminology. EIGRP is there, OSPF is there, RIP version 2, RIP NG, EIGRP for version 3, OSPF or EIGRP for IPv6, OSPF for version 3, they're there, NAT is there. The programming, this individual got a ton of questions on programming, I don't know why, and distribute list, I don't know why, okay? You shouldn't have asked that. Because again, it's a test based on multiple choice questions. Now, that's why on Wednesday, one of the things that I'm going to do is configuring, let's say, Spanning Tree the new way. It's not a new way; it's just the way they want you to do it now, like using root primary and root secondary. Never before. Also, when you're configuring the routing protocols, if you're doing IP version 4, you can do it the normal way. If you're doing IPv6, everything's under the interface. Some protocols, you need to turn them on, like EIGRP and router configuration mode, and give it a router ID. Others, just go straight into the interface and done, okay? You enable them on the interface. It's IPv6, okay? CCNP, okay? CCNP, when you're talking about now and CCNP, they're forcing you to go, okay, first answer me this. Who here thinks, who here thinks that BGP is a routing protocol? Or I'll state it even better, so you can give me a yes or no. Is BGP a routing protocol? Yes or no? Is BGP a routing protocol? It does. Packet trace has a lot of issues, but I mean, I've never had an issue crashing. If you put too much in it, it'll slow down. It may crash, but yeah, you just gotta work around the bugs. Martin is correct. No, it's an application. Thank you. Okay, BGP is not a routing protocol. It is not a routing protocol. It is an application. BGP is for ISPs. Now I'm glad you said that, Jason. Because you're right, it is, ISPs do use BGP. A lot of people just basically let their ISP handle their BGP, their transport, so they don't have to worry about it. They just create a default route and boom, they handle everything. But then that means you don't have any control over your policies. All right. No, Jason, anyone can use BGP. That's correct. Correct, Tech. I'm going there. Make sure you're running through the latest version of Packet Trace. Okay, yeah, that's 7.3.1, the latest version, 7.3.1 of Packet Tracer. In BGP is meant for ISPs. That is true. It is the protocol of the internet, okay? But in the new spine and leaf topology, okay, even though Cisco states that you'll be using ISIS, Louis Valle, which is one of my instructors on GlobeEd, is doing BGP for his spine and leaf because of all the different attributes that BGP has. And then you can control all those attributes based on prefix links and route maps and distribution lists and all that craziness. Okay? So there's a lot of flexibility and scalability with BGP that you can use in your internal network. And it works differently if you're doing an EBGP versus an IBGP session, right? And you have different communities and all these different things. So BGP, yes, it's a very it's scalable, it's flexible, it's very reliable, slow as molasses, but it does work very well. So BGP is not just anymore for the ISP. Now, with that said though, who said that? I think it was Tech. One thing is, I use BGP in my home lab to share prefixes between lab and physical.
Sure.
Okay. But that's your lab. Let me ask you this question, Tech. Can you decide at work? Let's say you're the boss at work, right? I'm your engineer. Can you tell me, hey, Laz, can you enable BGP on the core on our core edge router? And I just configure BGP. Can I do that? Yes or no? I keep putting these glasses on. I should do them on my head. Yep. Yes, you will. Data centers. All right. Data centers. You will do that. No, you can't. You can't just decide to run BGP because you want to. No, you can't. If it's you said private WAN, okay? You gotta be careful when you're doing BGP, because you better then filter out because it's over 900,000 routes on the internet. Okay, so if you don't filter properly, okay, you're gonna be in a world of hurt. And to do BGP with your ISP, okay, if you're doing that, there's paperwork and phone calls that need to be made, and the ISP needs to agree on that in order for you to be able to do it. And it's expensive. All right. Yes, if you're going between autonomous systems, sure, using BGP, your systems, you're using BGP, unless you're tunneling with another protocol. If you're going between autonomous systems, you're using BGP. What do you mean by that, Cisco? Cisco Ladder, if you're going between autonomous systems, you're using BGP. What do you mean by that? Why do you need BGP to go between autonomous systems? Why? BGP is a policy that big companies like, okay, BGP is compatible with most infrastructures, links, DSL, frame relay, and in fact, it's not broadcast. You have to tell who to peer with. Okay, you need to peer with. Yeah, you have your peering that you need to do. But peering only, yeah, well, MPLS, definitely, because you got your VPN V4s. Okay. Layer 3 VPNs, layer 2 VPNs. But when you're doing BGP, you got to be very careful. I'm looking at everybody's going back and forth here. Hold on. BGP is good. Friends with MP. That's true. Okay, it is. I'm just saying to be careful, because now when you get into, like, again, when CCNA BGP is Mickey Mouse, it's eBGP, they really don't tell you the truth about it. BGP is not a protocol that really you want to use to network with. Okay, you can create a BGP table, and when you peer with BGP to your neighbor. Because BGP does not have a view of the entire topology. It is your IGP that has the view of the entire topology. BGP just knows about its neighbors. And then if you create entries, like, you know, network, I'm connected to this network mask, whatever. I'm connected to this network mask, whatever. You can do that, okay? But it's not really the preferred method to do things, okay? And you can redistribute connected routes, all these different things. But you gotta be very, very careful. BGP is good, okay, over the internet. It's basically over the internet, okay, over the internet. All right. But again, you can do many things. There's so many things out there. Not everybody uses BGP. People will use, you know, where it's OSPF, or they'll just use their providers in charge of it. You can use DMVPN to get across the internet that way as well. All right. And IPsec now is a requirement in, that you need to know how to do. All right. So for CCNP, so I don't know how these brainiacs are doing. Everybody's getting certified as a CCNP with all these different terminologies. Just the fact that we went through IGNP and looked at all these PIM modes and all these terminologies as far as S, G and S, star, RP, you know, it's a rendezvous point and all these different things. And people don't really understand what the hell they're looking at, how they pass this test. But okay, BGP can kill your router in a second and your network if the path attributes are not configured properly. Yes, especially when you're connecting to two carriers. All multi-home, right? Multi-home BGP, definitely you got to be very careful with. That's why you get, you better do your filtering very well and what prefixes you're allowing. That's why when you're doing your route maps, they're facing a prefix list. Okay. You better make sure you're doing your greater than and your less than. I mean, greater than or equal to or less than or equal to. You better make sure that you know what you're doing. And that's where that funky wildcard mask came in. And I'm like, what? That doesn't exist. That doesn't exist. So, yeah, BGP is in use, but now it's in use also in the spine and leaf. Data centers. Cisco definition, Border Gateway Protocol is a standardized exterior gateway protocol designed to exchange routing and reachability information among. Yeah, but let me tell you something, Cisco Ladder. In the CCNP book, in the first couple of pages, it calls it a routing protocol. And then the other couple of pages, it says, well, we should think of BGP as an application. That's your definition. That's your definition on the website. I'm telling you, it was right in the book, okay? Between four CCIEs. They call it a routing protocol, and then they say we should think of it as an application. How about that? That's why I tell you, be very granular in your studying and get help, okay? So what is it, Jason? I'm nowhere near a CCIE, but use BGP every day. Good. Okay, understood. Listen, if you're using BGP every day, Cisco, that's awesome. That's awesome. So you're not going to have any issues. That chapter is so draining. It's not even funny. Okay, so it was always draining in the previous one, but even more so now when it comes to communities. All right, so, but yes, I'm glad that you do. All right, but runs optimally based on how stable is your IGP. Exactly, because it depends on your IGP. It depends on your IGP. All right, but anyway, bottom line, don't skip. Pick the correct book. Pick the correct courses from wherever you think, you know, wherever you like, but it's not whatever you like. Make sure they're correct. Trust but verify. Okay. And then if you're going on YouTube, make sure you watch the people that know what they're doing and always verify what they're saying. And then you try it. See what they're doing, then you try it to see if it's true or not true. Okay. Lab it up. I don't care if you're using Packet Tracer because you can do eBGP and Packet Tracer, but GNS3, you can do iBGP, eBGP, and there's big differences between one or the other. Imagine running eBGP, iBGP, EIGRP within the iBGP and RIP within the iBGP to another eBGP. How will you handle the redistribution at that point? And with BGP, you don't have to have a neighbor to peer to. Your neighbor could be two routers away. So you need to lab these things so you can fully understand what's going on. If you guys are not doing labs, you guys are not learning properly. I have highlighted per lab, but runs optimally based on how stable is your HBs. Okay, Jason, CCNA configure BGP all the time. CCNA, they probably won't let you touch BGP. No worries, Cisco. Tech Midas, focus definitely a must. Track your progress, yes, correct. If I'm wrong, Laz, EIGRP 100 routes, OSPF 50 routes per area. BGP is a limit. No, EIGRP, you're saying networks, the default is 100. The maximum is 255. You mean hops. As far as routes, how many routes are going to run? As many routes as they want. I mean, I don't I don't know if you're limiting EGRP to 100 routes. I don't know if you're talking about maximum path. Okay. Who's that? That was Martin. Are you talking about the maximum path? Because OSPF is unlimited. Oh, you said OSPF 50 routes per, oh, per area. How many routes per area? How many routes per autonomous system? That's really up to you. I mean, it depends on the type of traffic you have. And I think 50 is a number that I said I would have in an area. Because OSPF is really unlimited, but you have to have area zero. One of the labs that we'll be doing on Wednesday is an OSPF lab to prove to you, because I used to back in the day make fun and I would create area 51 and everybody would connect. Ah, ha, ha, ha. That's not reality. That's not reality. And the new packet tracer makes it real, where if you don't have area zero in your network, all area one will not connect to area two unless there's an area zero there. And I'll prove it to you on Wednesday. All right. So we'll be doing stuff like that to show you the importance and things that they can, a lab that they'll show a snippet on that they can create into a question very easily. You won't be going into routers, but you will definitely be going into you'll be going to the like images and saying, okay, based on this configuration, if I want to configure, what's the problem here? So there's things that you need to be aware of. And I was going to put in there, you need to know IPs. If you're still having problems with IPv4 and IPv6, and one of the things that I had to break down, okay, was summarizing, because they did such a great job in the book and summarization in the CCMP for IPv6 that I have to break it down even further, okay, because they did just such a wonderful job that I had to put my two cents in there, okay? So please, before you move on to the CCMP, okay, again, you can be a network individual with a BS, okay, in IT or programming or whatever the hell you got your BS in, underwater basket weaving, which there is such a thing. All right, guys, great chat, but got it. All right, take it easy, Tech. Thanks for being here, brother. Go get some study time. Cool. Thanks for joining. All right, I guess I've been on here too long. All right, so bottom line, I forgot what I was saying before. Let me see if somebody can refresh my memory here, what I was saying. Virtual links. Oh, what we were doing, what we're going to be doing. We're going to be doing, yeah, virtual links. We'll be doing the virtual link OSPF. We'll be doing the DR, BDR. We'll be doing the OSPF everything. We'll be doing the OSPF version 3. We'll be doing a lot of things on Wednesday. So go to GlobeBetter and register. It'll behoove you to go in there so you can see the new stuff and how to configure it, because it'll you not configure it, but it will come out on a snippet. If in OSPF, there must be at least one interface touching area zero. Yeah, there has to be some way that you get back to area zero, some way. Okay, now the LSAs, and we'll talk about it, the LSAs will change depending how far you are or where you're going, is it an exterior or your interior area or inter area, all right, or an exterior, type one, type two, all those things come in, but they don't go that deep as far as type one or type two, right? You're not going to make the difference, but understanding. But we will create virtual links so you can see how that works as well. All right, I've taken enough of your time. I just want you to be ready. Be ready. Okay, so this Wednesday, the ticker's been going on the whole time. Go to globet.net. It's Wednesday, 10 to 4. Some of you work, I know, I apologize. All right, but it's 10 to 4. If you can make the time, it'll be... it's a good investment for you. It'll be feasible for you to do that. It behooves you to do that so I can show you the things that people are having problems with, all right, and as far as configurations, because we will be configuring Packet Tracer, GNS3, whatever the case may be, all right, just to make sure. But this was a good, I'm glad all you guys joined in. Are stubs not, are not so stubs available? Not so stubby areas? That's still, I don't think we've gone that part of the CCMP yet. We haven't gone into, I think that's later on. We'll talk about that. But we're not going to get into that here. I can tell you that. I have started my CCMP study. What is the best lab for the Encore? Are you saying simulator, emulator, or lab? No, there's some good labs in there. There's some good labs in there where there's like five routers, router one, router five are their own autonomous system. Routers two, three, and four is an IBGP. Okay, that's a pretty cool lab they can do there. There's another lab where you have router two as the ABR, and then you have routers three, four, and five. 3-2-2 is EIGRP, 5-2 is OSPF, and then static routes from 4-2, and you have an EBGP hanging off to the side. All right, so that's a pretty cool redistribution router. Steps first, remember steps, get your TCP connection first. BGP should be the last thing you should be worried about, okay? And then, because you need your router, you need TCP connection, meaning point to point. And then once you got that going, then do your IGPs and static routes, and then worry about your BGP. And then worry about your BGP peering, and then your, you know, which autonomous systems and all that good stuff. Cool? All right, I just wanted to let you guys know that. And if anybody out there can prove me wrong on that 0.0, that 255.0, and I'm gonna put it one more time, okay, and I'm going to share it, or it is shared already, I think. Yep, it is shared. If somebody can prove me wrong on this mask based on a 26, this is based on this prefix right here. I don't care if you're doing a filter. This mask is invalid in my world. And I've asked already five different engineers with much experience and a double CCIE with much experience that says that no, that is wrong, all right? So prove me wrong if that's the case, all right? Other than that, I appreciate everybody joining. Be looking out. I'm gonna put it out not too far away, a live in Espanol, in Spanish, okay? So that's gonna be fun. It may be a little bit comedic, but it'll be fun, all right? So join in. Yes, we're CCMP and above. Otherwise, package range is fine. That's correct. All right, guys and gals, thanks for joining. Have a great day. Study hard. Burn the midnight oil, and you'll get your certification. All right, and remember, if you do go to college, get your BS and BS so you can BS your way through the HR department. Take care, guys.